So 25, you keep it in your mind. The square root of 25 is 5. Navachama ekadasha. Ekadasha is how much? 11. Ekadasha. 11 plus 25. We saw 25. Square root of 25 is 5. So 25 plus 11 is how much? 36. Square root of 36 is how much? 6. So navachama ekadasha cha metrayodasha cha metrayodasha cha metrayodasha is how much? 13. So now you can calculate. 36 plus 13. 36 we saw last time. 36 plus 13, 49. Square root of 49 is 7. So square root of all these numbers we are getting. 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is 25 we saw. 6 is 36 we saw. 7 is 49 we saw. Trayodasha cha me panchadasha cha me. So square root of 8. No, that becomes 64. 49 plus 15. Panchadasha means 15. Trayodasha, panchadasha, saptadasha. Next will come. Wait. Panchadasha, 15. 49 plus 15? 64. Square root of 64? 8. So, trayodasha, panchadasha, cha, saptadasha. Saptadasha cha me. I want that saptadasha also is saying me, to me. Me can also mean to me, chaturthi vibhakti me or mama me, mahiyam me or mama me, shashti also. Okay, that's a grammar, forget it. So, now where we are? So, 64. Square root of 64 is 8. Now 64 plus saptadasha. See, ekadasha cha me, trayodasha cha me, pancha 15, sapta 17, navadasha 19. So 9 9s are how much it will be? Come on, tell me. So when you add saptadasha, navadasha cha, navadasha is 19. So when you add 19 to what, you will get, I'm just giving you, waiting for some reaction. I know that you will react later on. So you got saptadasha. Now saptadasha plus navadasha will come. So, saptadasha, panchadasha, we finished. Saptadasha. So, 64 plus 17 is how much? 81. So, 81 square root is 9. Correct? Then, navadasha. Saptadasha, then navadasha. Navadasha is 19. So, 19 plus 81 is 100. So, 100 square root is 10. So, 9, 10. Likewise, if you know the Sanskrit numbers, navadasha cha me eka vigum shatihi means 21. So 100 plus 21, 121. 121 square root is 11. Eka vigum shatischa me trayo vigum shatischa me. Trayo vigum shatischa means trayo vigum shatihi. 3 means 3. 23. Vigum shati. Vimshati we say. Vimshati is 20. Eka vigum shatihi means 21. Trayo vigum shatihi is 23. So we got 100. We saw 100 is 10. Then 11 11s are 121 plus 23. 121 plus 23 is 144. So square root of 144 is 12. Trayo vigum satischa me, pancha vigum satischa me. 144 plus 12, pancha vigum shatihi means 25. So 169. 144 plus 25 is 169. So square root of 169 is 13. Pancha vigum satischa me, sapta vigum satischa me. 27. Pancha vigum after 27. 169 plus 27. 169 plus 27, 196. So 14. See, likewise, सप्तविगुं सतिश्च मे नवविगुं सतिः. सो 29. लाइकवाइज इफ यू ऐड, सी देयर इज अ arithmetic progression of number 2. So likewise you add, you will get up to 44. Chatvarigam sadishyame, chatus chatvarigam sadishyame, ashta chatvarigam. Ashta chatvarigam means 48. After that you can calculate, you can see the book. Everything will be the square root of that number. Plus if you see the arithmetic progression, it will be always 2. No, they could have picked arithmetic progression as 3 or 6, whatever number. Why they pick 2? Energy and matter, prakriti and energy, prakriti and matter, energy and matter. Einstein says if anything equation is energy is equal to mc squared, that's all. And then he squared, they are finding the square root, they are going in that way. There is a secret in this number. Number 2, the square root of the number 2 and the square of the numbers. They only squared the number, that's what. Then only they got the 4, the panchavigam, the number 4, trayovigam shadihi, eka chame, tisras chame, pancha chame, sapta chame, nava chame, eka dasha chame, everything they go by 2, and then they square root and brought the 2 here back. They squared the number and the square root of the number I told you. You can calculate. Sir, where is this beauty in any scripture, sir? They are praying to Shiva, Bhagavan. Who is praying? Dakshan. See, Daksha's intelligence. The knowledge of Daksha through a poetry, through a Vedic chanting, he brings out the pinnacle of intelligence, combined beautifully, interwoven, stitched beautifully with poetry and poetic knowledge and poetic stanza. Like you have eka chame cha me, everything me, to me or of me. And it was constructed so nicely through a prayer. And where do you get such intellectual usage? Application, an intellectual application woven through poetical genius, where do you get? You cannot get anywhere. Anyhow, this time, if it takes too much, I have to split and send the video. So I am stopping this and I shall continue later further. Till such time, Bhuyat Tavat Shubha Mangala. Thank you.